Hello, dear students. Today we start one more new chapter, triangles. So many things already we learned related to triangles. Triangle is a closed figure made up of three sides and three angles. That means in a triangle, some properties of triangle, all those you learned in your previous class, in your junior class. Now I will start. Congruent objects. What do you mean by congruent actually? This word also you heard in your previous class. Congruent means the object is having the same shape and same size. If it is a line segment, it is having same length. If it is a any object, it is having same size and same shape. They are equal. It is nothing but one is coincide in other or is superposed in other. So, definition of congruent objects. Two objects are said to be congruent if they have same shape and size. They have same shape and size. If you have to take two mathematics textbook, those are same in size and shape, so those two are congruent to each other. If you have to take two pens of same company, those two are congruent to each other. They are same in size and shape. Then only we can say the word congruent. Those two objects are congruent to each other. The word congruent means equal in all respects. All respects is nothing but equal in same length, same size. In all respects, those two are equal to each other. Now let us consider congruent of triangle. Congruent of line segment, all those you learnt. Here important is congruent of triangle. When you say these two triangles are congruent to each other. Two triangles are said to be congruent if the sides and angles of one triangle are equal to the corresponding sides and angles of the other triangle. So when you have to say these two triangles are congruent to each other, they are the sides of angles means the congruent side of corresponding side of these two are similar to the other triangle. Two triangles are said to be congruent. The sides and angles of one triangle are, this triangle are equal to the corresponding sides and angles of the other triangle. I will discuss what you mean by corresponding. Okay, so here ABC is one triangle, PQR is another triangle. These two triangles are congruent to each other. This is a congruent symbol. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. So here AB is, see one line is given, AB is equal to PQ. AB is equal to PQ. And BC is equal to QR and AC is equal to RP or PR. These are corresponding sides. That means you have to take this triangle ABC and place on PQR this triangle ABC, superpose or coincide on PQR because these two are having same size and same shape. Similarly, angle A is equal to angle B is equal to angle Q, and angle C is equal to angle R. So these are corresponding sides. AB is corresponds to PQ. It is nothing but what? If you have to take and place here, these two sides will be equal. So these two are AB is corresponds to PQ, BC is corresponds to QR, and AC is corresponds to PR. These are corresponding sides of these two triangles. Similarly, corresponding angles are angle A is equal to angle B. So angle A is corresponds to P. Angle B is equal to angle Q. Angle B is, will coincide on angle Q. Angle C is equal to angle R. These two are corresponding angles. Corresponding angles. A is corresponds to P. B is corresponds to Q. And C is corresponds to R. It is nothing but corresponding is nothing but they are equal. They are equal. Angle A is equal to angle B. Angle B is equal to angle Q and angle C is equal to angle R. So what is the corresponding symbol? See, A is corresponds to P. Both side arrow mark, it indicates correspondence symbol. A is corresponds to P, B is corresponds to Q and C is corresponds to R. When we have to say these two triangles are congruent to each other, these two, see, said to be congruent if the sides and angles of sides and angles of one triangle are equal to the corresponding sides and angles of the other side. Corresponding sides are nothing but what? AB is corresponding to BQ, BC is corresponding to QR, and AC is corresponding to PR. These corresponding sides are equal and corresponding angles are equal. Then only we have to say these two are congruent to each other. After seeing these, I have to say we have to discuss one note. CPCT, usually you use the CPCT. It stands for corresponding parts of congruent triangle. These are corresponding sides and corresponding angles are CPCT. Is nothing but what? Corresponding parts of congruent triangle. What are corresponding parts of congruent triangle? Corresponding sides and corresponding angles are CPCT. Is nothing but what? Corresponding parts of congruent triangle. This symbol is congruent to. Usually we'll use these two triangles are congruent. Is nothing but what? This is a corresponding. Sorry, this is a congruent symbol. This is a congruent symbol. So these are some definitions, very basic knowledge you need to understand. Now I'll discuss some criteria for congruence of triangle. What are the criteria? Some criteria we have already learned all these criteria in your previous class in 7th standard. Again, we need to discuss these criteria. By using these criteria, we need to solve some questions. First one is SAS congruence rule. SAS stands for what? Side angle side. Side angle side congruence criteria. It states that two triangles are congruent according to SAS congruence rule. Two triangles are congruent if two sides and the included angle of one triangle are equal to the two sides and the included angle of the other two triangle. Once again, two triangles are congruent if two sides and the included angle. See, two sides and the included angle of one triangle are equal to the two sides and the included angle of the other two sides. See, two triangles. Here ABC and PQ are congruent to each other by SAS rule. See, here AB is corresponding to PQ, AC is corresponding to PR, and the angle A is inclined. Inclined means it includes these two. See that two triangles are congruent if two sides and the included angle means these two sides, it includes this angle. So inclined angle. So inclined angle, this angle and this angle are equal. Here AB is equal to PQ and AC is equal to PR. Two sides and one included angle of one triangle are equal to the other triangle. Then we say these two triangles are congruent to each other by SAS. Two sides, SAS. Two sides and one included angle of one triangle are equal to the two sides and one included angle of other triangle are equal. Then we say these two triangles are congruent to each other by SAS congruence rule. Here AB is equal to PQ. Here given here, this is very important. AB is equal to, represent here, AB is equal to PQ, AC is equal to PR, and angle A is equal to angle P. Therefore, by side angle side congruent rule, we can say these two triangles are congruent to each other by SAS congruent rule. So, this is the first rule in criteria for congruence of triangle. Now, I will discuss second rule. Before that, I will take one example based on this rule. By using SAS congruence rule, first rule, I will discuss one example now. In figure, OA is equal to OB and OD is equal to OC. In this figure, OA is equal to OB. OA is equal to OB and OD is equal to OC. OD is equal to OC given here. Show that triangle AOD, triangle AOD is congruent to triangle BOC. These two triangles are congruent to each other. First question. And second one is AD is parallel to BC. AD is parallel to BC. We need to prove. So it is given that OA is equal to OB and OD is equal to OC. To prove, what do you want to prove? Two questions. One, two. Prove. In triangle AOD and triangle BOC, these two triangles, AO is equal to BO and CO is equal to DO. AO is equal to BO and CO is equal to DO. It is given. It is given. And angle AOD is equal to angle AOD. This angle is equal to BOC. BOC. These two angles are equal to each other because these two are vertically opposite angles. See, two sides and one included angle of one triangle, this triangle, are equal to two sides and one included angle of other triangle, then we say these two triangles are congruent to each other by SAS congruence rule. See, therefore, by saying this one, triangle AOD is congruent to triangle BOC by SAS congruent rule. These two triangles are congruent to each other by SAS rule. Now, second question is, prove AD is parallel to BC. See, angle OAD, this angle, and angle BOC, angle B. Angle AOD is equal to angle CBO or OBC. OBC, this angle. This is OBC. OBC. These two are equal. These two are equal because these two are alternate angles. See? Otherwise, we can say, yes, we can take BOC also. BOC also. BOC. BOC is this one. So, CBO or OBC. So, angle OAD. Angle OAD is equal to angle CBO or OBC. These two angles are alternate interior angles. If these two alternate interior angles are equal, we say these two sides are parallel to each other. Therefore, AD is parallel to BC. Converse of interior alternate angles theorem. If these two interior alternate angles, these two will be alternate alternate angles, these two sides are parallel to each other. This AB gives us transversal. AB is a transversal. Transversal makes so many types of angles. So, here BC is parallel to AD. This is the solution about the exam. Now, there's the second rule, ASA rule. It states that two triangles are congruent if two angles and the included side of one triangle are equal to the two angles and the included side of other triangle. This is the just reverse of that, is SAS, here ASA. So, two angles, angle B is equal to angle Q and angle C is equal to angle R, and BC is included side for these two because it includes these two angles. Similarly, QR includes these two angles. Here BC is corresponds to QR, angle B is corresponds to angle Q, angle C is corresponds to angle R, angle B is equal to angle Q, angle C is equal to angle R, and angle C is equal to angle, sorry, BC, angle C is equal to angle R, BC is equal to QR. Automatically, this AB side will be equal to PQ. So, in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, angle B is equal to angle Q, and angle C is equal to angle R, and BC is equal to QR. Two angles and one included side of one triangle, two angles, one included side of one triangle are equal to two angles and one side of other triangle are equal, then we say these two triangles are congruent to each other by ASA congruent rule. This is the second rule. Some more criteria for congruence of triangle. Already two criteria discussed. Now, AAS congruent rule. When we have to say these two triangles are congruent to each other by AAS rule, two triangles are congruent if any two pairs of angle and one pair of corresponding sides are equal. Here, any two pair of angles and one side of a triangle are equal to the any two pair of angles and one side. In the previous ASA, there are two angles and one included side of one triangle are equal to the two angles and one included side of the other triangle are equal, then we say those two are congruent to each other by ASA. But in this case, any two pairs, either AB is equal to PQ, and these two angles are equal. These two angles are correspondent. Or we can take this side also. AC is equal to PR. In triangle ABC and triangle PQR, angle B is equal to angle Q. Angle B is equal to angle Q and angle C is equal to angle R. And AB is equal to PQ or AC is equal to PR. Either this side is equal to this side. Suppose this side is equal to this side and this side is equal to this side, automatically base will be equal. So therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR by AAS congruence rule. AAS congruence rule. Then included side, two angles and included side of one triangle are equal to the two angles and an included side of other triangle are equal. Then we can say those two are congruent to each other by AAS rule. But in this case, two triangles, when we have to take, so say these two are congruent to each other, two triangles are congruent. If any two pairs of angle and one pair of corresponding sides are equal. So any two pairs of angles and one side, not particularly the side here. Either this side or this side we have to take. But in the previous case, only this side only, BC only, because these two angles and this is the included side. I hope you understood. This is AAS rule. Now I will discuss one example based on AAS congruent rule. Example, line segment AB is parallel to another line segment CD. AB and CD are parallel to each other. O is the midpoint of AB. O is the midpoint of AD is nothing but what? AO is equal to DO. So that first condition, triangle AOB is congruent to triangle DOC. Triangle AOB is congruent to triangle DOC. First we have to prove. Second is O is also the midpoint of BC. Note O is the midpoint of AD is given. We need to prove O is also the midpoint of BC. We need to prove. It is given that AB is parallel to CD and AO is equal to DO. It is given. To prove triangle AOB is congruent to triangle DOC, this is the first question. Second one is OE is also the midpoint of BC. Prove. First condition. In triangle AOB and triangle DOC, AO is equal to DO. AO is equal to DO. It is given. It is given. Angle 1 is equal to, mention, consider this is angle 1, this is angle 2. Angle 1 is equal to angle 2. So these two are parallel. So these two angles are interior alternate angles. These two are alternate angles. So always alternate angles will be equal. Next, angle AOB is equal to angle DOC. Angle AOB, this angle is equal to angle DOC, this angle. These two angles are equal to each other because these are vertically opposite. Therefore, triangle AOB is congruent to triangle DOC by AAS rule. See, AA, see, these two angles are alternate angles, these two are vertically opposite angles. Two angles and one side of one triangle are equal to two angles and one side of other triangle by AAS congruent criteria. These two triangles are congruent to each other. If these two are congruent to each other, therefore, BO is equal to CO. BO is equal to CO. AO is equal to DO already given. These two are parallel. So automatically DO is equal to CO or CO is equal to BO because CPCT. CPCT stands for what? Corresponding parts of congruence of triangles. So second one also proved. This is a solution about example. This example.